Right. And welcome to this session for the How to Meditate on the Discovering Buddhism. And this is the preliminary meditation, warming up for the teachings with Venerable Veena. And the meditation will be in two parts. The first one is a little shorter. It's the 9 round breathing, once more, like last week. It was demonstrated by Venerable Veena at the teachings. And first of all, remember that we actually are breathing with the body right now. So the body is part of the meditation. And the reason for starting any meditation with this is that it steadies the energy. It's making you calm, giving your mental balance, preparing your mind for the second part of the meditation, which is a visualization on Buddha Shakyamuni. So it's a really suitable practice and technique. And there are 3 sets of breathing. There's the left, there's the right, and then there's both nostrils breathing in and breathing out. I'm just gonna give a little short intro and then I'm going to demonstrate along the way. So for the first part of the meditation, we're going to block the left nostril and through the right nostril, inhale pure, clean, white light, purifying all negativities and obscurations in our mental continuum, while switching to the opposite nostril, exhale as dark smoke, all the attachment energy. And that's what we're going to do now. So block left nostril and inhale 3 times. Consider holding your breath just for a short moment and then exhale. In the second part, we block the right nostril and through the left nostril, inhale pure, clean, white light that purifies all negativities from aversion energy, anger, and any frustration that we might have. Hold it and exhale 2 more times. The last 3rd round, we inhale through both nostrils and inhaling white purifying light that pushes out all the dark smoke from ignorance. Now put some confidence in that you have actually purified as best as you can all the negativities from attachment, aversion, and ignorance, thereby also hopefully removing some of the obscurations that prevent you from achieving just a baby step of realizations on the next practice. It's a meditation on the Buddha, Buddha Shakyamuni. Just as always, we start with generating strong motivation for doing this practice. Ask yourself, why and for whom am I doing this? Perhaps it's because you want to become a kinder person, better person, enabling others to feel better, be at service towards others, developing, generating as much love and compassion and kindness and as possible. So see this practice as a means to increasing your energy with all the qualities, all the positive attributes of the Buddha. And now begin the visualization of the Buddha. When you visualize, you use your mind, no longer the body, but you visualize the mind to draw or create an image. So it's not an activity of the eyes or the body. You use your mind to visualize, to create an image, a mental image. And this entire visualization is made up of light. Every aspect is made of light. So that means it's transparent, not solid. Try to think of it as a rainbow. When a rainbow appears in the sky, you can see the colors. But sometimes it's very bright, but there isn't anything solid at all. If you were to try to touch the rainbow, it would be impossible. Can't hold on to a rainbow. This visualization should ideally be similar to that. It's just pure, transparent, radiant light. Imagine Buddha in the space in front of you, about a level of your forehead and about 2 meters away. And the Buddha is seated on a lotus with its petals spread out flat. On top of the lotus, there are 2 flat discs of light like cushions. They represent the sun and the moon. They're round and flat and made of light, also radiant. Upon the lotus, moon and sun is seated the Buddha with his legs crossed in a full lotus position. He's wearing the robes of a monk, which are saffron colored. His right hand is on the right knee in the gesture of touching the earth. The palm of his hand is against the knee and his fingers are outstretched, pointing downwards, touching the seat beneath him. In his left hand, he holds a bowl filled with nectar. His left hand is resting on his lap in a meditation position, with the palm facing upwards and the bowl resting on the palm of his hand. The Buddha's body is made of golden light, transparent, radiant, and completely pure. The Buddha's face is very beautiful, and his smiling, compassionate gaze is directed at you and at the same time towards every living being. And his expression shows that he's free of all judging, critical thoughts, or anger. There are no negative thoughts at all in his mind towards you or towards anyone else. He completely accepts it just as we are, with pure, unconditional loving kindness and compassion. Try to refresh the visualization, all the little details. Think about all his bodily attributes and think about that they are all filled with love and compassion for us, for every sentient being. It might be a little difficult to remembering all the details or sticking to the visualization itself. You might also just think about it as clear, strong light, like the sun rising in the horizon, giving you a warmth, light, courage. Do your best to keep with the visualization and be content that whatever you are thinking about, even if it's not that clear or perfect, the most important thing is that you feel that the Buddha is there and feeling full of loving kindness towards us. Feel the presence of the Buddha with all his qualities, universal, unconditional loving kindness, compassion and wisdom and skillful means, all other enlightened qualities existing there in the space in front of you. And while you feel those qualities, feel the loving kindness radiating towards you and all sentient beings. Think about all these rays coming from his heart chakra, going to your brow, your throat chakra, and your heart chakra. Just stay with this visualization for a minute or two. Think that all these powerful laser beams of purifying loving kindness light comes into your body, and your body just can't hold onto it anymore. And it bursts, and the light continues towards all sentient beings around you. And the powerful light illuminates sentient beings around you. Just like a candle, when it leans towards another candle, they illuminate each other, and the flame gets even stronger by doing so. It doesn't diminish, it gets stronger, grows and grows. Now return to your motivation from the beginning. Maybe your motivation was to become a kinder person, spread some love, be a better version of yourself, help other sentient beings around you. But see yourself as this candle that leans towards other sentient beings and thereby illuminating their light. And while doing so, even your flame gets more powerful. Think about how for the rest of the day and maybe tomorrow, you will be like this candle, lending the light to others. And while doing so, your own flame will also burn better, become stronger. During the teachings today and for the rest of the evening, or while rewatching this video online, also think of the purifying energy and the beams of loving kindness that they continue. They're never stopping. Even if you let go of the thought of Buddha Shakyamuni, And while this meditation is coming to a conclusion, we'll dedicate all of our collective efforts for the past 15, 16 minutes to all sentient beings. May they meet a spiritual friend who can awaken their Buddha potential. And may every sentient being meet the Buddha Dharma and achieve enlightenment as quickly as possible. And may we be the cause for this to happen. May we give them the light. We also dedicate this collection of merits to all of our lamas and precious teachers, and in particular His Holiness the Dalai Lama. May he live long and always be a precious guru in lives to come. We also dedicate to Lama Tsopa Rinpoche and Kandurara. Rejoice in all the precious teachings that Rinpoche is currently bestowing upon us from Kathmandu. We can watch them online. And may Rinpoche continue to be a beacon of light for the FPMT organization and inspire centers to do meditations and courses like this one. And we also dedicate to all of our precious teachers and lamas, without whom we would be lost with no understanding of the teachings. May all of our teachers live a happy life, and may we meet them again in future lives. Thank you very much.